Well, good morning. We're glad that you are with us today. It's Monday. Yay, we love Mondays. But we've got something good that we're going to be sharing with you over this next few days. We've kind of a theme here, at least Monday through Wednesday. And the theme is believing and perceiving. And you know, Marcia, you said something a week ago on Wednesday night when you ministered, I thought it was really good, is about that you saw yourself as an encourager, you know, and really and truly that's what we want to do on these devotions. That's is right. We want to encourage each one of you to receive and live the very best life that God has for you. And I believe God's for us, you know, he is not against us. You know, he's not trying to tear us down. He's always in his word trying to build us up. Yes, there's correction, and we all need correction sometimes in our life, but he doesn't knock you down to correct you. Okay. Amen. His word brings correction, and his Holy Spirit brings correction.
That's not his nature, is it?
It is not his nature. So this morning, if you have your Bibles, we're going to look at Romans chapter 8 and verse 37. And he says this right here, yet even in the midst of all these things, and Paul has just gone through a scenario of all of the challenges that he's had in his life and all the things that have gone, we would say gone wrong, you know. Yeah. He said, yet even in the midst of all these things, we triumph over them all, for God has made us to be more than conquerors. And his demonstrated love is our glorious victory over everything.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God has established a position for us, right?
The position. More than conquerors.
Yes, that we're, and notice he says there that God has made, so that's past tense.
Oh, yes.
So that position is already there. That position is there whether you ever take that position or not.
Jesus Christ established that for us.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Everything he did on the cross, everything he did, for redemption. He redeemed us from not being conquerors. Why aren't we conquerors then?
You know, Marcia, I think you and I both, you've gone to church longer than I have. You know, you've got all the little pins, Sunday school pins to prove it, you know. But I think a lot of people can go to church and believe, you know, that this is the Word of God, but never really see themselves in that Word.
That's right.
You know what I mean? They don't perceive that is for them.
Yeah, the Word has to become real to them. That's for me. That is me.
Right. We use a word called revelation.
Right.
You know, when we came into the Word movement, we came across this word revelation, and I looked that up, what the definition of revelation is, because there are points in yours and my life that we call them revelation in our life, don't we?
You
know.
Right.
Well, here's what the definition of revelation means: a surprising and previously unknown fact, a fact, especially one that is made known in a dramatic way. It is a declaration. It is an utterance. It is an acknowledgement. It is admission, and as we've been teaching a lot, it is a confession, which means to say the same thing in 1
say
John.
Say the same thing as the Word says.
Yes,
that's
yes.
Right. You know, the Bible calls us kings and priests.
Amen.
In Revelation 1:6, it says, and has made us kings and priests to God and Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. So that needs to be a revelation to us that we are kings and priests on this earth.
Amen.
Unto the Father, but to others around us. We don't go around saying, oh, I'm a king. But you are a king in God's eyes. And, you know, we're world overcomers.
Amen.
Talk about
that's right.
Being that.
1 John chapter 5, verse 4.
It says, you see, every child of God overcomes the world. Every child of God
overcomes
the world. For our faith is the victorious power that triumphs over the world.
You know, we have to believe something is for us to be able to use our faith to get it, don't
That's
we?
Right.
To receive that, you know, if we're going to receive.
We have to have that revelation.
Yes,
we?
Yes, absolutely. If I'm talking about healing, then I have to have the revelation the acknowledgement or the confession that I see myself in there healed.
That's
and
right.
And when I see myself healed, don't I? I speak in a different way, right?
That's
I talk
right.
in a different
we
way.
We do. We
praise
do.
God. Well, we love you. We bless you today. We pray that God will watch over you and take care of you today. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for your blessings in their lives today and in ours. Thank you, Lord, for loving them.
Yes, Lord.
Put your arms around them and let them know that they are loved by you. We thank you for this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Be blessed.